YouTube, what's up? Back at you with another video. We're here with the MJ the Musical trailer, I guess you could call it that. This is one of the couple of videos that they got that's in anticipation of the musical coming out next month. And only reason why I'm doing this video is because I had a couple of people or a few people ask me my thoughts as far as, you know, the musical and if I'm going to go see it. And, you know, just like, you know what I'm saying, a little shit like that. So I'm gonna watch this and then I guess I'm just gonna give my thoughts because I've kind of had my opinions about it for a while. So, you know, without saying much more, let's just get into it.
Opening MJ on Broadway means the world to me. It's an incredible honor.
I ain't smiling for this shit.
Opening MJ on Broadway means the world to me. It's an incredible honor, and I'm so humbled to be able to represent Michael Jackson.
The only reason I'm smiling is because of the music, man. That was corny. All right. Well, okay. So, hold on, man. Let me watch maybe one other one of these motherfuckers real quick, and then I'll go from there. This is just the music, man. This music just makes me happy. That's the only reason why I'm smiling. Okay. All right. So basically, they're not giving people too much as far as, you know,
at Hilton.
Wow, shut the fuck up. So they're not giving people, you know, a lot to go off of as far as the promotion. So we're not seeing any rehearsals. You know, I mean, okay. So my real thoughts are, shout out to Myles Frost, you know, for getting that opportunity. You know, he seems like an actor. You know what I'm saying? I'm an actor myself, so. You know, I ain't hating on him. I think my critiques about the MJ musical really comes from the fact that you can't get anybody to really be Michael Jackson. Because to be Michael Jackson, like, you can't do it. Like, you have to be him. And you're setting up that actor for failure. Like, you know, to be honest with you, and I've said this to a lot of people. It's just like if someone asked me, like, oh, you know, would you be Michael Jackson? You know, would you be the role of Michael? So basically, okay. So if someone were to offer me the role of Michael Jackson, I would say no, because I cannot be Michael Jackson. Like, I don't think I could ever convince someone, oh, that I am him. Only maybe little ass kids, but a grown ass adult, I couldn't do that, and I wouldn't want to do that either. Like, if you look at my videos on my channel, I always make it so that way it's Michael right there and then it's me. It's never like me trying to be him, you know, because the fantasy that I've always had, you know, in my life is always just to be able to get up on stage and dance with him. That's all I ever wanted, was to be on stage with Michael and get to just, you know, do choreography with him. So my videos is basically me kind of getting to live that out in a way, you know, because I always kind of wanted to see how I would, you know, measure up next to him. I also think that the musical is not necessary, and I speak for a lot of fans that I see on Twitter where every time they promote this thing, people are asking for, oh, where's the Dangerous documentary? You know what I'm saying? Where's the new album? You know, this and that. It's like the Michael Jackson estate, or, you know, what it's like to be a Michael Jackson fan is like the Krusty Krab, and then to be a Prince fan is the Shell Shack.
Hey, Tom!
Fred! Hey, you want to eat at the Krusty Krab?
Nah, let's go to the Shell Shack. They've got a talking dog.
Great! Say, what's a dog?
If y'all are, you know, a SpongeBob fan, basically it's like, if you're a Prince fan, they got the Prince Originals albums. They got, you know, different, you know, cool releases and things like that. So it's still fun to be a Prince fan. The last time we got a new Michael Jackson album was in 2014. that Michael Jackson Halloween thing, to me, that don't count. I liked it, you know, the first time that I saw it, but to me, that's not what I would really want as a Michael Jackson fan. The only way that they'd really be able to pull this off correctly, because we're not going to really know how good it is until, like, we actually go see it. Me, personally, I will not see it. I will probably see some footage on the internet, and I'll probably kind of, like, make my, you know, decision off of that. Another thing that kind of turned me off about this thing was that they hired the Talauega Brothers to come on and work with Myles. As far as I know, that's what I read, to work with him on how to get the movements down or some shit like that. And initially, they had, what was his name? Ephraim Sykes? Some shit. Basically, they had another actor that was initially going to be Michael Jackson. And I had actually saw him, a performance of them doing a Temptations record. And the same guy was David Ruffin in the Temptations Broadway show. And I didn't like his performance at all. Like, it just, David Ruffin is 6'3". 6'4", you know what I'm saying? And he wasn't, like, all on the floor doing the most.
Boy, if you don't get...
It's like, you never saw that. Like, so, after that, I was like, this is the guy that you gonna get? And I was worried. I was like, damn, like, you know, I don't think that it's in good hands. So the fact that they had to get the Talauega Brothers to come on and help this guy recreate Michael Jackson's movements, to me, is already a red flag, because I feel like if you're going to get somebody that's actually been doing it their whole entire life. You know what I'm saying? Or has like a relative like starting point, and then you can develop from there. But this guy, I mean, I don't know. It seems really manufactured to me. You know, I think that the state, whatever budget that they used to put this thing together, I feel like they could have used that to do a whole bunch of cooler stuff. Like, and like, this is my thing, right? I feel like the estate should be, you know, making another documentary like what we got with, you know, Bad 25 or Off the Wall, you know, documentary. They need to call Spike and then get Spike to do another documentary and then have a simultaneous, you know, new album. And then the thing with the albums, and I agree with John Barnes, if anybody knows who John Barnes is, he's a musician, songwriter that worked with Michael Jackson for pretty, like, maybe like 15, 20 years. So I guess maybe from the early 80s to about the mid-late 90s, I think. And then he kind of, you know, left Michael's circle, you know, temporarily. And they need to get these people who were on Michael's A team and B team and get these people back to remaster and rework these records. Don't get Timberland and all these contemporary producers to, you know what I'm saying? Like, they might fuck around and get Soulja Boy to produce, you know, an unreleased Michael Jackson track. And, you know, I'm not feeling that. And I've watched, you know, certain, I've watched certain interviews, and then they express, you know, their frustration at the fact that, you know, they're not keeping certain aspects of Michael Jackson's legacy alive. It's like everything that they do, it seems like a, you know, like disingenuous money grab, you know. And Michael Jackson's legacy really stood for, like, you know, a lot. Like, it's just so many layers to what he left behind, and it's like we're only getting like the top commercial, you know, mainstream layer. We're not getting like the heart and soul of, you know, what he left behind for us to consume, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, again, this is no knock to Myles Frost at all. This is not to say that, oh, I should be doing this shit, because I wouldn't want to be known as the Michael Jackson guy, you know what I'm saying? What else? Yeah, if I had my way, I'm like, if anybody, you know, of note is seeing this shit, I would do more interviews, you know, more documentaries with Steve Porcaro, John Barnes, you know what I'm saying? Those are the two guys that I'd like love to talk to. His choreographers, the directors that he's worked with. Like, this is what I want to see as a Michael Jackson fan. I don't want to see, you know, no Michael Jackson musical and then some guy is supposed to be Michael Jackson. Like, the last time, the only person who ever successfully played Michael Jackson was Wylie Draper, rest in peace. He's the only one that actually played Michael Jackson and convinced me. I mean, I was a little kid, and then even now, I would still watch American Dream right now and still have a good time, and I won't feel like, ah, this is not Michael, man. Nah, I won't feel like that. But with this kid, he don't look like Michael Jackson. He wasn't, he, like, I mean, and mind you, I seen that little, I skimmed through the video where it was his mother and his grandma, his sister, his teacher and all this shit. I skimmed through it. And, you know, they're saying, oh, he was spinning. Like, a lot of people know how to moonwalk. Everybody knows how to spin. But knowing how to dance like Michael Jackson is, you know, two completely different things. Again, I could be wrong. You know, they could probably do it right. But at the same time, it's like, yo, I haven't seen the shows that are out in Vegas. But the shows in Vegas, hey, I've heard good things about them. So why can't they just leave it at that and then create better shit? Like, no, I don't know. That's just me personally. Because I think this is catered to Michael Jackson casuals that will just take anything, because there are a sector of Michael Jackson fans out there that will just take anything that they can get. They're so hungry for Michael Jackson content that they will literally take anything and then not, you know, like actually critique or just say, nah, you know what? Nah, I'm not going to really support that. And I'll wait till you guys actually come out with something, you know, of real substance. So, you know, I'm going to say again, this is not a knock to Myles Frost. I respect Myles Frost from an acting standpoint. They gave him an opportunity. He said yes, and he's going to do his best with what he was given. This is more so a critique of, you know, the people behind all this shit, the people who sat and thought, oh, we're going to do a Michael Jackson musical, and we're going to have people, we're going to have two actors that are going to pretend to be Michael Jackson. This is like, no. The only way I see this going well is if they're just doing a series of performances. So it's not that like, oh, he's portraying Michael Jackson. It should just be more, they're just paying tribute to his songs and his music. So I don't believe that there's going to be any dialogue in this shit. It doesn't seem like it to me. They're just, you know, it's just going to be maybe 10, 12 performances, and they're going to start from the Jackson 5 era, and then they're going to go to the very end. So, you know, we'll see. And I have heard, you know, some shit about, you know, some of these producers or the people, you know, behind this shit really kind of being not in Michael Jackson's favor. But, you know, for shit like that is exactly why he's not here, because you had a lot of people who, you know, were on his team and part of his camp, Conrad Murray. And, you know, they did have his best interest, clearly, because if that wasn't the case, then maybe Michael Jackson would still be here today and we wouldn't be having these Fugazi, you know, Michael Jackson musicals and shit like that. But again, you know, I'm not hating. I'm just, you know, keeping it above. People ask me for my opinion, so that's just my opinion. You know, if you want to go see that shit, go see it. And, you know, that's that. But I think the estate should keep their ear to what the fans are asking for, because, like I said, the Prince Originals album to me was like the coolest thing in the world, because we got to hear, you know, the original version, the demo track for Jungle Love. You know what I'm saying? We got to hear Gigolos Get Lonely Too, because I'm a big Morris Day and a Time fan, you know, if you couldn't tell. And I always wanted to know, dang, like, what would Prince, you know, like, what would Prince's version sound like? And, you know, we got that. I'm not like the biggest Prince fan in the world, but because I'm a fan of Morris Day, you know, I'm a fan of Prince by default, because Prince wrote a lot of, you know, Morris Day and the Time material. So, yeah, like, listen to your fans. Like, if people are asking you, hey, we want this, then give them what they're asking for. Don't ignore your fans, you know what I'm saying, and then just make whatever the fuck you want, however the fuck you want to make it, you know what I'm saying? Like, I just don't believe that they're going about it the right way, and I feel justified in that, because people who knew him personally, they feel the same way. So I think that's pretty much it. So again, shout out to Myles Frost, you know, from actor to actor, you know what I'm saying, performer to performer, I respect it and shit like that. Do your thing, bro. And yeah, with that said, I will see you on the next one. Peace.
Good luck.